Welcome to Retro Machines. My name is Victor Bart, and in this video we're gonna talk about how you should store your CPUs. So this is my current box with CPUs, and as you can see it's pretty full, and this is not the best way to store them because the CPUs are sliding over each other and they are just stacked in this box. We have Pentiums, Pentium with MMX, Celerons, AMDs, Pentium 3, Celerons, 486, 286, 386, some Xeons. So we need to have a better solution than this. So the solution where I'm looking for is that the CPUs are really protected, that they are protected against bent pins, and that it is easy to pick up the storage solution and move it around. My studio is pretty small, so the solution must be very compact. And it must be easy to find the right CPU without taking them off each other, like my current solution. So my solution is CPU trays. And I really like the CPU trays like this. You can put in from Pentium 1s up to Pentium 3s and even higher clocked AMDs. So it's compatible with socket 5, socket 7, socket 370, socket A, socket 462. So it's a really nice solution for a pretty long era of CPUs. But I didn't bought one CPU tray. I bought 20 CPU trays. And I found them for €4 each by a Dutch eBay seller. I can store 10 CPUs per tray, so with 20 trays I can store up to 200 CPUs, but I don't own 200 CPUs, but my plan is just to fill them up with one type of CPU, and if it's full I just take another one on top of it. So it's really easy to find the right CPU back, and you don't have to swap them around because you don't have enough trays. So let's fill them up. Let's start with the Celerons. Now we're gonna do the Intel Pentium 3s. Let's do the AMDs, and they are all K62 CPUs. Let's do the higher clocked Intel Celerons. And let's put in the CPU terminator from the Abit VP6 here. Let's do the Intel Pentiums. Now let's do the Intel Pentiums with MMX. And also the Cyrix and IBM 686 will fit in here, because they are socket 7. So this is a much nicer solution than the carton box, and you can easily pick them up. So now I have a proper solution to store the CPUs. I'm probably gonna put stickers here so I know which tray is what kind of CPU. And the pins are protected, and you can easily find the right CPU that you need. It's a pretty compact solution. For example, you can put it in a small drawer if you only stack a few, or you just make a big pile and put it on a shelf. I think this is a really decent investment if you have a lot of CPUs. And if you search around, you can probably find other sized CPU trays. For example, for the Intel Xeon CPUs, or maybe you can still find them for the 486 CPUs. Maybe I need to get a few of those also. This size CPU tray, the 49mm by the 49mm, is compatible with the biggest range of CPUs, from Pentium 1 up to Pentium 3 and even higher clocked AMDs also. Thanks for watching. Please like and share this video, subscribe and leave a comment. You can join Retro Machines on Facebook, and you can support me monthly on Patreon.
A reminder that the Black Mesa Hazard Course Decathlon will commence this evening at 1900 hours in the Level 3 facility. The semi-finals for high security personnel will be announced in a separate secure access transmission. Remember, more lives than your own may depend on your fitness.